The Elevation with Stephen Furtick podcast was created with you in mind. This is a podcast for those feeling discouraged or needing guidance from God. Together in this podcast, we'll dive deep into scripture, uncover the powerful truths that will help you rise above your limitations and embrace your full potential. We're here to equip you with the tools you need to conquer life's challenges. Listen to Elevation with Stephen Furtick every Sunday and Friday on the iHeartRadio app, Apple Podcasts, or wherever you get your podcasts.
I used to have so many men.
How this beguiling woman in her 50s...
She looked like a million bucks.
...scams a bunch of famous athletes out of untold fortunes...
Nearly $10 million was all gone.
It's just unbelievable.
Hide your money in your old rich man, because she is on the prowl.
Listen to Queen of the Con, Season 5, The Athlete Whisperer, on the iHeartRadio app, Apple Podcasts, or wherever you get your podcasts.
Danielle Moody here, host of the Woke AF Daily podcast. We've been with iHeart for a year, and what a year it has been. As we head deeper into 2024 and yet another life-changing election cycle, Woke AF Daily is here to keep you sane and woke. Make Woke AF Daily your podcast destination for 2024 election news and analysis. Listen to Woke AF Daily Season 5 on the iHeart Radio app, Apple Podcasts, or wherever you get your podcasts.
Oh, hi, I'm Rachel Zoe, and my podcast Climbing in Heels is back and better than ever. You might know me from the Rachel Zoe Project, or perhaps from my work as a celebrity stylist. And guess what? I'm still just as obsessed with all things fashion, beauty, and business. Climbing in Heels is all about celebrating the stories of extraordinary women, and this season is here to bring you a weekly dose of glamour, inspiration, and fun. Listen to Climbing in Heels every Friday on the iHeartRadio app, Apple Podcasts, or wherever you get your podcasts.
Before we get started, a warning that there will be depictions of death and violence in today's episode. Hello, from Wonder Media Network, I'm Jenny Kaplan, and this is Womanica. Historically, women have been told to make themselves smaller, to diminish themselves. Some have used that idea to their advantage, disappearing into new identities. For others, a disappearance was the end to their stories, but the beginning of a new chapter of their legacies. This month, we're telling the stories of these women. We're talking about disappearing acts. The year is 1918. A family is asleep and under house arrest. They're awoken during the middle of the night and told to put on their clothes in a hurry. The children rub the sleep out of their eyes and look around at the guards who surround them. The commander tells them not to worry. They will soon be taken to a safe house. Just come downstairs. All will be well. Or so they thought. This was the empty promise that began the elusive legacy of today's womanikin. Let's talk about Anastasia Romanov. Anastasia was born just outside of St. Petersburg, Russia, in 1901. She wasn't an ordinary girl born into an ordinary family. Her parents, Nicholas II and Alexandra, were Tsar and Tsarina of Russia. Anastasia was part of the Romanov dynasty, the family that had ruled the country for nearly 300 years. Anastasia had three older sisters, Olga, Tatiana, and Maria, with whom she was incredibly close. There are several photos of the four girls together wearing identical white lace dresses and floppy sun hats. Some of them were even taken by Anastasia herself. Friends and family described Anastasia as sharp and clever, with a penchant for getting into trouble. She loved to play pranks on her siblings and enjoyed being the center of attention. Though she had a strong personality, Anastasia's younger brother, Alexei, was often the family's focus. He was frequently housebound due to a bleeding disorder. As the only male heir to the throne, his survival was critical to maintaining the royal line, especially during a time of political upheaval. The children grew up during a contentious period in Russian politics under their father's rule. Russia's roles in the Russo-Japanese War and World War I brought terrible casualties that left the country in a state of disarray. Russians were increasingly unhappy with the leadership, and unrest grew. The infamous Russian mystic Anastasia's mother called in to care for Alexei, Grigory Rasputin, further alienated the Romanovs from the Russian people. There was a growing movement to abolish the Russian monarchy and adopt a communist government instead. The family knew its position was precarious. in February of 1917, the struggle for power in Russia reached a boiling point. Workers began to strike, demanding better working conditions. But when Nicholas sent his army to quell the unrest, members of the military turned against him, unhappy with the defeats they'd been facing on the war front. Local protests morphed into a bigger revolution. They called for the end of the monarchy. Not long after, the revolutionaries took over. Nicholas abdicated the throne and a provisional government was put into place. Soon, the Bolsheviks, a communist group, had taken full control. After being forced to abdicate, Nicholas took his family and fled the scene. They were eventually exiled to the Ural Mountains and placed under house arrest. They lived there in relative quiet until they were awoken one fateful day in July of 1918. Under the pretext of providing the family with better security, the Bolshevik leader told them to go down to the cellar. The family and staff went downstairs. When they reached the cellar, gunmen were brought in and began to shoot at them. One soldier recalled the execution as a shower of hail. Soldiers began firing with abandon, many missing their intended targets. Fumes and gun smoke filled the space, making it hard to see. Bullets ricocheted off jewels embedded in the Romanovs' clothing, hitting the walls. The violence went on for 20 minutes. At last, the room seemed quiet. All that remained was the heavy breathing of the soldiers, the bodies burned and buried in a clearing near a cluster of birch trees. This is the end of Anastasia's short life story. But her ghost lived on much longer. Just a few years after the Romanovs were killed, a woman named Anna Anderson popped up in Berlin claiming to be the supposedly dead Duchess Anastasia. She said she'd survived the shooting and escaped her assailants. Her account was convincing. Sure, she looked like Anastasia, but people were desperate for a glimmer of hope, or maybe mystery, for someone to have survived the violent massacre. Within months of her announcement, Russians began visiting the so-called Anastasia to pay their respects. But it was all a lie. Anna died in 1984, and posthumous genetic testing proved that she was not actually the fallen Duchess. Further confusion around the DNA evidence at the gravesite also gave people reason to pause and wonder what actually happened. Though 11 people were executed, only 9 sets of remains were initially found. DNA evidence of Prince Alexei and one of his sisters appeared to be missing. This mystery was also put to bed in 2007 when a group of archaeologists discovered a second gravesite. This one contained the remains of 2 more people who have since been identified as the missing members of the family. Despite evidence pointing to the death of the whole Romanov family, some refused to accept that Anastasia was among those who lost their lives. In fact, nearly 100 different people have claimed to be the long-lost Anastasia since the execution. Countless films, books, and shows have been generated from the romanticized story of her disappearance. Whether Anastasia truly disappeared or not, the lore around her life and family lives on. The continued fascination with her life seems, in many ways, to be a manifestation of people's desires for hope, in spite of insurmountable odds. All month, we're talking about disappearing acts. For more information, find us on Facebook and Instagram at Womanica Podcast. Special thanks to Liz Kaplan, my favorite sister and co-creator. Talk to you on Monday.
The Elevation with Stephen Furtick podcast was created with you in mind. This is a podcast for those feeling discouraged or needing guidance from God. Together in this podcast, we'll dive deep into scripture, uncover the powerful truths that will help you rise above your limitations and embrace your full potential. We're here to equip you with the tools you need to conquer life's challenges. Listen to Elevation with Stephen Furtick every Sunday and Friday on the iHeartRadio app, Apple Podcasts, or wherever you get your podcasts.
Danielle Moody here, host of the Woke AF Daily podcast. We've been with iHeart for a year, and what a year it has been. As we head deeper into 2024 and yet another life-changing election cycle, Woke AF Daily is here to keep you sane and woke. Make Woke AF Daily your podcast destination for 2024 election news and analysis. Listen to Woke AF Daily Season 5 on the iHeartRadio app, Apple Podcasts, or wherever you get your podcasts.
Oh, hi, I'm Rachel Zoe, and my podcast, Climbing in Heels, is back and better than ever. You might know me from the Rachel Zoe Project, or perhaps from my work as a celebrity stylist. And guess what? I'm still just as obsessed with all things fashion, beauty, and business. Climbing in Heels is all about celebrating the stories of extraordinary women, and this season is here to bring you a weekly dose of glamour, inspiration, and fun. Listen to Climbing in Heels every Friday on the iHeartRadio app, Apple Podcasts, or wherever you get your podcasts.
I'm Hannah Storm, and my new podcast, NBA DNA with Hannah Storm, chronicles my 6 decades in professional basketball, from growing up in the sport to becoming one of sports TV's first female broadcasters. Join me as I dig deep into the game's history, unearth some wild stories, and talk to my friends from the world of basketball, from Dr. J to Charles Barkley. It's been a wild ride, and now I get to take you with me. Listen to NBA DNA with Hannah Storm on the iHeartRadio app, Apple Podcasts, or wherever you get your podcasts.